We primarily are focused on small, medium-sized farms, socioeconomically disadvantaged farmers, underrepresented minority farm groups. So that's pretty much been our target, the focus of where our work is from a component in Virginia Cooperative Extension. There's the misnomer in the 1890 community sometimes that people feel that the work that go on at our universities is only targeted toward the Black community. Nothing could be further from the truth, because we view ourselves as scientists, we view ourselves as extension specialists, we view ourselves as being on the leading edge of us outreach and engagement in science. And so our target audience is not defined by race, though we have a specific interest and work with underrepresented audiences and communities of color. Certainly that's in our wheelhouse and that's near and dear to what we do. But the productivity and the capabilities of our research span beyond just that community. You know, COVID showed us that many of the audiences that we now serve and work with could adjust and would utilize technologies. So specifically for small schools like Virginia State and many of the other 1890s, when we switched to online format with technologies, we really didn't know how it would turn out. But we found that we've seen an uptick in program participation and viewership, people tuning in, participating in our programs. Now, we can't say whether that's because people were just home and didn't have other things to do, or whether it's an actual that the way it is designed and the timing of it is convenient for people because they can tune in, they can view, they can do it from afar. Well, I certainly would think that the one thing African-American farmers would say here is, we are here. Do not judge us by our size and scope. We have the capability of contributing, and we have the capability and capacity to deliver. The thing that they would also ask is that the differential being between us and the much larger scale and majority farmers is the investment in us. And so I think that African-American farmers and large organizations would say, if we can get the investment and we can have access to the technologies, we can also deliver on American agriculture and be a part of it. If we are to meet the global food production goals that have been set forward for 2050, it certainly cannot be done by only traditional agriculture or the traditional faces of agriculture in America. I'm proud of the fact that here in the Commonwealth that we have the two land grant universities, Virginia Tech and Virginia State Universities, and that we, from a cooperative extension perspective, we function as one system that is supported by two universities. And I think that our partnership should be seen as a model or an example across the country of how two institutions from divergent backgrounds and starting points can come together and work for the total good of the Commonwealth and all of its citizens. And that programming that we do span the spectrum of all of society within Commonwealth.